Read me back the last line.
Read me back the last line.
Not my last line, somebody else's.
George Clooney's new Hulu miniseries, Catch-22, is based on Joseph Heller's famous World War II novel of the same name. But what's the true story of Catch-22? Joseph Heller biographer Tracy Daugherty says,
"The novel was based very much on his experiences in the military."
Joseph Heller served as a bombardier in the 340th Bomb Group based on the island of Corsica.
"The man here on this side is my dad as base as commander. And this person right here is Joe Heller himself. My father was the final commander of the 340th Bomb Group at that time. And he has the dubious honor of being the seed for Colonel Cathcart in Catch-22.
"Some of you will not be coming back."
Which is not flattering, it's not complimentary, but that's as it is.
Patricia Chapman Meder wrote about the bomb group in her book, The True Story of Catch-22.
"Heller just had this incredible wit, and it was dark humor, and he poked fun at everybody. But he would start with just the kernel of the seed of a personality, and then he would build on it. But that seed was so big, you couldn't miss who it was."
Meder says the bomb group served an important role in the European theater.
"They were flying the B-25 Mitchell.
The long-range land bombers, B-25s. Mitchells, they call them.
Their main mission was to disrupt German corridors of getting supplies and getting their men back and forth. So, especially between Italy and Austria, they kept at those targets. And they became so good that they earned the nickname of the Bridge Busters, because bridges were the very hardest thing to hit. They're narrow, you have to pinpoint hit them, and you're releasing your bombs like 2 miles away. They went 3 months at one point with a 90% consecutive hit success rate."
Though the bomb group was often successful, their missions were incredibly dangerous.
"In 1944, Joseph Heller was on his 37th mission. He was supposed to bomb a bridge over Avignon, France that day, and the plane got hit by German aircraft fire and flak, and he really thought he was going to die. And that mission that he barely survived became the basis for Catch-22.
Heller's alter ego in the books is a bombardier named Yossarian, who finds himself in both real and existential peril.
"It doesn't make a difference who wins the war to someone who's dead."
It keeps flashing onto the particular mission where his plane gets hit, and a comrade of his gets seriously wounded. And Yossarian tries to heal him, tries to patch up his wound as the plane is buckling all around them. And then he realizes the wound is much worse than he thought. He can't save the man. And in a sense, he can't save himself.
Yossarian and Heller felt trapped in a cycle of military demands.
In the military, in Heller's case, it meant that he was caught in a series of missions. He had to keep flying bombing missions. And the commanders told him, when you reach a certain limit, you'll be done. Well, he reached that limit and they kept upping it. So the war became endless and he was caught in this loop.
"I have decided to raise the mission count from 25 to 30.
We're gonna win this thing. Hip, hip.
And I asked my dad about that and he said, "Well, yes, I did raise the missions, but the order comes from above me." You know, the level was above him, but he executed it. So that was very true. He did raise the missions.
"I've flown more missions than anybody on this base, and every time I get closer, they raise it on me."
Fortunately, Heller survived the war.
Heller flew 60 missions, and he was a good soldier. He did what he was told, and he did it well.
After the military, he got a job as an advertising writer and lived the life of Don Draper from the Mad Men series. That was very much Joseph Heller's life.
He went on to write Catch-22, which mirrored his experiences.
He began by laying out index cards with names of all the people he had served with in the Army and all the missions he had flown, and that became the first outline for Catch-22, which he published in 1961.
In the book, Yossarian tries to avoid flying missions and finds himself in military bureaucratic limbo.
"To get out of flying more bombing missions, you have to say that you're mentally unfit, you're crazy. But if you don't want to place yourself in danger, you're really not crazy.
You can ground me if I'm crazy, right?
Oh, sure, I have to. I have to ground anyone who's crazy.
Then ground me. I'm crazy.
You're not crazy.
Why not?
Catch-22. As soon as you ask to get out of combat duty, you're no longer crazy, and so you have to fly more missions.
And thanks to the success of the book, the term Catch-22 entered everyday use.
That's some catch, that Catch-22.
It's the best there is.
The basic idea behind the concept of Catch-22 is one rule tells you you have to do one thing. Another rule tells you you have to do something else. They contradict each other. You can't do both, and so you're paralyzed.
Catch-22 resonated with a young generation dealing with its own military conflict.
As the Vietnam War heated up in the 1960s, readers took it up as an anti-war novel and almost saw it as a Vietnam novel.
An allegory for the absurdity of bureaucracy and war rooted in real life.
For all these years, people have assumed it was fiction and marvelous fiction, but it really wasn't. The characters, never has a great work of art ever matched so carefully with actual figures.
This is InsideEdition.com.